Good morning, friends. Today's topic is art of speaking. We know how much words are important in our life. Human being is given with two very unique features, faculties. One is his or her advanced intellect, which is not to be found in any other living beings, so developed brain. And that brain alone wouldn't do anything. That brain with the power of speaking makes a real human being. If we were very intelligent as we are, but we had no communication with others through speech, each of us would be an island, not relating ourselves to other human beings. And without being related to others, there will be no joy of life. Someone said, if you want to be happy, you need to be connected with all. If you want to remain alone at the cost of other human beings and want to be happy, it won't be possible. For the sake of imagination, if suppose there was only one person living in the world with every facility there, suppose planes will fly and there will be big hotels and there will be good food and you can go anywhere, you can go live in any house, but would that person be happy? Suppose not only him, his family, husband, wife, and children would be there, but no other person in the world. And he has plenty of money and plenty of resources to do whatever he likes or she likes, but there are no people to interact. There are no people to communicate. There are no people to relate. Will that person be happy? No. We need human beings, other human beings with whom we have friendly terms, with whom we are yet to have friendly terms. Not so friendly term, but to change that unfriendly relation into friendly relation is the thing where it gives great joy. If we put one friend out of one enemy, that would be so fruitful and so joyful an event. So we need human beings. And only our developed intellect, developed brain, would be of no use to us as far as our life is concerned if we had no power to speak. Speech is the thing which connects us with others, but that speech is also the thing which also makes us distant from others. Words are so powerful. They say the pen is mightier than word, mightier than sword. Words are powerful than guns. They can inflict such a deep wound in a person. Words can break or save lives. Words can make enemies or friends. Words can start or create peace. That is the power of words which come through speech. Speech, we all speak, but as there is art of living, how one should live to have the full joy of living, how one should die to have the joy of dying. There is the art of dying also. One should be prepared to die. That's what Hindus say. Swami Vivekananda used to say, the Hindu's whole life is preparation for that moment when he will leave this world and go to the eternal life. That's called the moment of death. The art of dying is art of life, living is a preparation to art of dying. And then, to have this art of living successful, we need art of speaking or art of speech. We all speak words, but we need speech therapy as it were. You have heard the term speech therapy. Children are there, they have defective speaking. They don't have speaking power. They don't know to speak properly. And that is all of us we also don't know what should we speak, how should we speak, and as we are ignorant of speaking, we all need speech therapy. We all need to learn and know what should we really speak to be a real human being, having known to speak out. So today I'd like to discuss something which I gathered from many sources, from the books and from some other speakers. So speech actually comes from our thoughts. The source of speaking is our mind. They say there are different gradations of speech. It's called para, paschanti, madhyama, vak. Para is unknown to us, very deep into our mind. Then thought come in a subtle way, that becomes paschanti. You start thinking that not clear. Then madhyama, then it comes, you are clearly thinking. Then that thought comes into vak. Speech is the manifested thought, and thought is unspoken speech. That's what relation between thought and speech. So ultimately it comes to have a good speaking, we need to have pure mind. Mind is all. The wonderful song that was sung today in such a wonderful way presented, all said about how one can be a good devotee. Vaishnava Jana is the term, but in generally it means devotee, a lover of God, what he can do or she can do, what or he, she can be in the world. Those all qualities were said by Narasimha Mehta about a devotee of God, a lover of God. What a fantastic change comes. If we can be lover of God, all our these thoughts and speech will all automatically be just right. Buddha, in his Ashtanga Marga, he said one of his eightfold path to attain Nirvana was speech. Have the right speech, wholesome speech. That is one very important part of conducting your life to attain the highest reality, highest knowledge. And what he says about this speech, what is the Samyak speech or wholesome speech? He said the wholesome speech is abstaining from false speech. Never try to make stories and try to impress upon others. You will be at loss. So speak the truth. Never say deliberate lies to others. There are lies, white lies, and some jokingly say there is still greater than white lie. It's called statistics. Somebody said lies, white lies, and statistics. But Buddha said, abstain from false speech. And he said, abstain from slanderous speech. Don't use malicious words. Don't, on the back of others, don't criticize others. Be pure. Don't, when we criticize, what happens? We start looking something defect of that person in our heart, in our mind. And mind becomes polluted, and that sensation of our mind comes in the words, in the form of speech to the third person. Don't use those things. Try the cleaning that not speaking malicious words is the not expressing the thought. But finally, when we abstain from not expressing our thoughts about others, then those thoughts are subsided. When we speak those words and we speak the criticizing words, then those are more get strength and mind gets more agitated and those grow inside the mind, the thought about others, malicious thoughts. Don't speak malicious thoughts. Not speaking ill about others will ultimately make us not see ill about others and our mind will be purified. A purified mind is a mind of a lover of God. Whether he is a devotee, he is a believer in God, doesn't matter. He is a man, good man, a genuine person. So I believe in God, that is one thing. A person who doesn't believe in God but follows all the dictum of good living or spiritual living, doesn't even believe in spirit perhaps, but if followed all the dicta of spiritual living, he is a holy man in our sense. That's why Buddha never said of God. In Buddhism, there is no place of God, but it is a religion. Human being become perfect with the following the teachings of Buddha. So one who does that doesn't speak ill about others. He is a holy man. Abstain from harsh words, he said, that offend or hurt others. We can hurt, as we said in the introduction, that how words can hurt others so indelibly. Something said is not forgotten. Something wound is healed up, but the wound in the heart is not forgotten. Abstain from harsh words that offend or hurt others. Then another thing in the wholesome speech is speaking good words, beneficial words, and not hurting others through words. And another point, the fourth point, is abstain from idle chatter. We often talk of something which has no relevance to our life. Little conversation is good, but to make it deep and chattering for a long time, which doesn't have anything to do with our life, is also not helpful to in pursuing our goal, which we want to attain, the spiritual goal. In Vedanta, it is said, Anya Vacho Vimunchata. Give up other talks, other idle talks. Only remain in the pursuit of what you are searching. To think of that and talk of that. If you love God, talk about God. There are so many ways to talk about God. We have seen in the life of Sri Ramakrishna, whole day he used to talk nothing but God. And people used to come and listen to him. Every day, the whole gospel is full of how to improve ourselves, how to love God, how to love everyone. That is in the book. That with all holy men, Ramana Maharshi's book, if you read, it is the same thing. If you read Bible, it is the same thing. All about improving ourselves. That is the real purpose of speaking. This is what the Buddha said. Now, our Bhagavad Gita has said that there are three types of austerities. Austerity or tapas has been said as the means to attain the highest reality. One small devotee or child goes to a teacher in Upanishadic age to the Upanishad and he asks, Adhihi Bhagavo Brahmeti. Lord, Father was his teacher, teach me Brahman. Adhihi Bhagavo Brahmeti. Then Father said, what is this question? Teach me Brahman, what does it mean? So the father said, Brahman cannot be taught like that. He says, then he said, to practice him austerity. He says, tapasa brahma vijigyasasva. Practice austerity, practice tapas. By tapas you will understand Brahman. Brahman is not something that can be given from one person to another. But you have to have the knowledge of Brahman by yourself. How will I have? That much teacher can do. You do this, and you will reach the goal. You have to walk yourself. You have to eat yourself to get the nourishment. You have to practice yourself spirituality to attain the highest knowledge of the reality. Then he said, tapasa brahma vijigyasasva. Practice tapas. Practice austerity. What is austerity? That is not described there. But in the Gita, which is the explanation of the Upanishad, Sarvopanishado Gavo Dogdha Gopalanandana. Upanishads, all the Upanishads are like the cows. And who milks the cow? It is Gopalanandana, the child of Nanda. The Sri Krishna milks the cows. Dogdha Gopalanandana. Partho Vatsa Sudhir Bhokta. Dugdham Gita Gita Amritam Mahat. Gita is the milk. And how did this milk come? Oh, this Gopala milk from the Upanishads. And how was it initiated? As the calf initiates cow to give milk by having the first coming and putting its mouth in udder, it was Arjuna who inspired and initiated the milk coming from the cow through his question to Krishna. And for whom the milk is made? Milk is not for the calf, milk is for the human beings. So, here human beings are the wise persons, are the one who will drink this milk coming out from the Upanishad in the form of the Gita. Gita is the milk. Gita, Dudham, Amritam, Mahat, is the great nectar of the milk of Upanishads, is the Gita. In that Gita, Sri Krishna describes three kinds of austerities, tapas. And in three kinds, physical tapas, Tapas of speech and tapas of mind. Three kinds of austerity: physical, herbal, and mental. Herbal speech, that is our topic today, he said. What are the qualities of speech that it will be counted as the tapas of speech and the austerity of speech, and that is the art of speech. What is that? Anudvega karam vakyam. Your words should be anudvega kara. It should not be disturbing. Disturbing to whom? Disturbing to others. Very important. When we speak, we should be aware that we are not creating disturbance in that person. We are not hurting that person. So always it has everything. It should be very good and congenial and friendly speech. Anudvega karam vakyam. Then what are the characteristics to practice tapas of speech? It should be, we should speak something that will not hurt others. Then satyam. It has to be truthful. You cannot speak something that is very good and you just make other person to float in the sky saying all false words. That is called flattery. Flattery is not the something anudvega karma or praising words. What someone defines, what is flattery? Flattery is speaking about a person of the qualities which that person doesn't have, he or she doesn't have, and you say, oh, you sing so well, but the songs were not that good. But you still say, you also know that it was not good. And you also know that person is not a good singer. But you say in praise, oh, you sang like so great a musician, like Elvis Presley or like Lata Mangeshkar. Then it will be flattery without having full knowledge that that person doesn't have that quality, and you say that person has. And that is not hurting that person or making that person happy. Anudvega, not hurting anyone by the word. And satyam, it has to be truthful. What will happen if it is not truth? What is there if some person sang not so good? Should we go and say, hello, come here, your song today was very bad. Oh, it was so disheartening, I didn't like. How did you sing that way? No. There comes then Chanakya Sloka. Satyam Priyat, Priyam Priyat, Ma Priyat, Satyam Apriyam. Speak only pleasant truth. Satyam Priyat, Priyam Priyat. Speak the truth, speak the pleasant words. Ma Priyat, Satyam Apriyam. What will happen if something is there, truth is there that he didn't do well, he didn't speak well, there is nothing to praise? Then should I praise him in a wrong way? Apriya, Ma Priyat, Satyam Apriyam. It is a truth, but it is unpleasant. Should I speak that? Mahapriya. Don't speak unpleasant truth. Don't speak unpleasant truth. Keep quiet. Somebody has done something and you don't like that, keep quiet. Don't say anything. You don't have to go and be, I am a very truthful person. I express whatever is in my mind. I didn't like, I have to say. I don't have two mouths that in mind something and speak something. Sri Ramakrishna said, make mind and mouth one. Heart should tally with the mouth and go and say, oh, it's, what you did was so wrong. I felt like going away from that. Don't say that. That's what the Niti says. Sri Ramakrishna also, when he said, make mind and mouth one, means don't speak that which is not in your mind. Don't flatter others. That he said. But you don't have to always go and speak whatever you have seen or you have felt. Satyam cha nanritam bhuyat. But something is truth, and then it is anritam. Then priyam cha nanritam priyat. Something is very pleasant, but untruth. So don't speak that. Satyam priyat, priyam priyat, ma priyat, satyam apriyam. Priyam cha nanritam priyat, esha dharma sanatana. What is it? That is the sanatana dharma. That is the eternal law. Sanatana dharma doesn't mean a religion professed by some person. Sanatana Dharma means eternal law of the human beings. That always speak what is pleasant and what is truthful. So if it is not truth and pleasant, don't speak that. If it is truth and unpleasant, don't speak that even. Keep quiet that time. So these words are so important. Thoughts of the speaker convert into words. When we speak, what happens? How these thoughts and words are interconvertible. When I am speaking, I'm thinking something in my mind, and it comes Parapashyanti Madhyama, and then vak, and vak it comes. And then vak goes to your ear. And there it hurts your eardrum, and then from there it converts into another way, just a reverse way, and goes inside you as thought. So words and thought are interconvertible. We should be, to keep our words good, we have to have our minds good. Now, how should we should use our words in world to make it a better world, to make ourselves a better person? So first, I was reading that, as we are saying that, anudvega karam vakyam satyam priya. So speak, in that is that priya, speaking the present words, good words itself is a tapas of speech. So we need to discriminate or discern what is priya and what is apriya. I think that person will not mind, I should speak that. So I spoke and he heard that person. That should not be there. Sri Ramakrishna, though he said, make mind and mouth one, express whatever is in your mind. But he is the one, he says, don't say a lame man. How you became lame? How you got your leg cut? Don't hurt him because he is lame. Just ask politely, what made you like this? Don't hurt by words, even in asking the things. So, Sri Ramakrishna recommends that. Now, this how these words, you know, has changed our this thing, our life. Satyam priya, it's anudvega karam vakyam, satyam priya hitam jaya. Then hitam, always speak beneficial words. That is the austerity of speech. Beneficial, which will be good to other person. When you speak something which is good to other person, that will be good to yourself. It is all about loving other person, respecting other person. And when we respect other person, we ourselves are respected. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, always seek to respect others. Don't have any thought for your own respect. Amanina manadena. The more you give respect to others, you are respected by the world. That's how the world is. And when you seek to respect, to gain respect yourself, the world says, oh, he's a very arrogant man. World will not look to you. Then the last of this thing, then I come to another way. Last of this tapas of speech is swadhyaya abhyasanam chaiva. After speaking and communicating that way, it said you should practice abhyasanam of swadhyaya, of studying books, reading books. That is also austerity of speech, and that also will make you a better person and ultimately will lead you to the highest truth. Speak good books. Books also, there are so many books. So here swadhyaya means studying of the Vedas, of the scriptures. But anywhere you find that the books which are helpful for your goal of life, those are good books for you. Those are like scriptures, like swadhyaya doing. That is also a part of reading. Earlier time, there used to be reciting. There were no books when this Upanishad said this. So when the Gita said, we don't know there were books or not, but earlier there were no books, so swadhyaya was like reciting whatever you have heard from a teacher. So practicing what the scriptures say, going and reading and rereading the books, the congenial for your life, that is called swadhyaya. So these five types of words used become the austerity of speech. This is Vāṅmayam tapujyate, Sri Krishna says. Now when we go on conversing with each other, how to do that? How to talk with others? So we know what should we talk. But the thing is, there are some techniques how we should relate when we converse with each other. So one, they say, you must acknowledge when you hear something from others. You go to someone and he's telling you some story or she's saying you something. So what should be our attitude? Our attitude should be, we should listen patiently and we should listen attentively and we should make the person feel that yes, I am listening to what you say. We should acknowledge the hearing of other person. This acknowledgement, someone is saying your mind is somewhere else, that person will not enjoy in speaking to you. It will be futile. That will not be the art of speaking. Art of speaking has to relate with art of listening. Because when you speak, other listens. When others speak, you listen. So listening and speaking also go together. When others speak, then you must acknowledge for others what others are speaking. That is one thing that is needed when we talk with each other. And acknowledgement can be done through asking questions. That's one very nice thing. Or through showing that, yes, I am listening. So that person should be aware that you are listening to him or her. So that is one important thing. Another is in speaking the thing, priya hitam. What is priya? We need to appreciate for others any work. That is also art of speaking. Appreciation. We should not be miser in using words of appreciation in the world. People, we may be miser in giving money or wealth or something or time, but words do not take any money. You can use profusely the words of appreciation. Again, the appreciation is not the flattery. We have to keep in mind that thing. Appreciation is something that is true, just to expressing what you feel. Often we just keep quiet, keep silent. We don't feel like, we don't feel the need of expressing others' good qualities. And if we have this ability to express and appreciate, we can find good quality in every person that we need to search. And we need to speak. The beautiful verse in Sanskrit, it says, Priya Vakya Pradhanena Sarve Tushyanti Jantava. All beings, all living beings feel very happy and satisfied when they hear good words. Who are the all beings? Human beings, even animals. If we say good words to a dog, he feels. To a pet, if you say good word, he feels how you are speaking. So, it doesn't take anything. Tasmat tadeva bhaktavyam vachane ka daritrata. Why you are stingy in using good words? Why you are so miserly in using good words? Everybody like that. If you appreciate his or her quality, his or her some action, that's what we do. When people sing some song, so oh, today you sang very nice. A little food, and it comes in a house. It's not only in when you come to the temple or some gathering. It comes in the house. When your son does some work, you can appreciate, oh, you did that very well. When some wife does cooks very good food, oh, this type of food was so delicious. Just saying, eating as if something she is supposed to always cook good, and you don't speak anything, that is not there. You should try to appreciate what others do for you. That is also art of speaking. And that makes a good relation, good feeling. And while speaking, how can we find good words? The scriptures say, in fact, in one of this Niti Shatakama Bhartrihari, it has said that we should train ourselves to see whatever good we have of a mountain into a mole, and make others mole into a mountain. Not to criticize others, but to see good thing in others. Something good you see in that, make it a mountain. Manasi vatasi kare punya piyusa varsha tribhuvana mukkukara sreni vipreena yanta paragunam paramanun parvati kritya nityam paragunam paramanu, very little, like a paramanu, small, insignificant, like a small mole, it is there. And do it parvati kritya nityam, always make it like a mountain. Nijaguna vikaras santa santis kshiyanta, and always reduce your qualities. Don't speak. That's what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said. Amanina manadena. Always give honor to others. Don't seek any honor to yourself. And that is the way, art of living. Don't seek any honor. Don't seek any name and fame. If you avoid seeking name and fame, then you will be really happy person. If you seek, then you are in trouble. That's what all the teachers say. So appreciation is very important art of speaking. Another part of how to speak is when we go to someone consoling others. There are times when people want to hear some words. And when they are in trouble, there is nothing more healing than good, kind words. Patients go to doctor, they will find doctors. They are very truthful doctors and they are very good doctors also. One person went to a doctor and he said, "Oh, this ailment, I went to India and they said, now this your pain, it will not go and this thing will last only for 10 years, your this surgery, this knee transplantation, and after that you will have trouble." He goes to doctor here and he says, "No, you have got very nice treatment done there. Why 10 years? It will last a lifetime. Don't worry." And that person was so happy to hear this. So much of this console she got to hear. She didn't give a time limit. You can't give a time limit to anything. So like that, consoling a person always gives strength in that person and gives a lot of joy. The doctor didn't give any medicine, didn't treat anything, just he said, he gave the words of inspiration, words of hope for that person. That person was so happy. Swami Vivekananda said, how these good words help. He said, one person tired of his living in some England or Ireland, comes to US, and there he was hopeless. Everybody said, "You cannot do anything, you are good for nothing, you are very weak," and somehow he immigrates to US in olden times, and here he lands on the shore, and he said, "Pat, you are like us, you can do everything." Just people start saying, and give him just inspiration, good words, words of hope, words of power, and that person thinks, "Yes, I am also a man," and he stands up erect, he starts working, and it's a beautiful and very standard life. So that's how the words of consolation and inspiration helps us. Always that should be there. Always inspiring others and showing the positive things. Every human heart has got some positive qualities. Man is divine. That's what the real nature is. That divinity can be manifested if it is little expressed and inspired. Even when the story in today our reading was from Valmiki Ramayana. When Hanuman was supposed to cross the ocean was big, and Hanuman thought, how can he do? Then how did he cross? His friends, they said, "Hanuman, you don't know who you are? You are the son of air god, Vayu Devata, you are so powerful, you can do anything," like that they said. And inspired him such a way, he really felt who I am. So inspiration just rouses the power that is hidden in us, hidden in the human being. That's what the inspiration is. And consolation can balm all the problems of life. Going to a person who is in need and giving the few words of consolation is always a part of speaking. Giving joy to others is the purpose of life, the Buddha said. And Holy Mother, how she did, about the consolation. You have to, consolation doesn't come from the mouth. If it comes from the mouth, it doesn't touch other person. When other person is in need of some good words, it has to come from the real feeling. Once to Holy Mother came a hawker who used to carry weight. So that was a very poor woman, and her son used to take the things, purchase things, the groceries to Holy Mother. So one day that his mother came, and the Holy Mother asked, "I don't see you quite often, and your son, the young son, used to bring the grocery. Why did he bring today?" He said, then she started crying and said, "My, that grown up young son died a few months ago." And she was a widow, and it was a terrible shock for that only support and died. That woman started crying. Hearing that woman had lost her only son, Holy Mother felt so bad and so pain, she started crying even louder than that woman whose son had died. Not a few months, few weeks, her son had died. And that was so great a consolation to that woman that after some time she was very much consoled, and after talking with Holy Mother something, and then after that when she returned, she was very peaceful. So Holy Mother's speak in that way was very consoling. And that consolation didn't come from words, but came from the feeling. When we could feel for the suffering and pain of others, words will automatically come that will console others. The main thing is our mind has to feel. From the mind will come the words that will really console other persons. So we need to be to share the words. But while consoling, we should be very careful. We go to console some person has died, some person is great, some type of misery and bereavement, then we should be careful not to give advice. Not to say that, oh, that person, your husband died, but he was drinking too much, that's why his liver got it. Don't say that. It will be very bad. While consoling, you start giving advice and you start criticizing the life of the person. We should be very careful not to hurt other person. So then it will be just reverse thing. It will just backfire to us. If we criticize while consoling, start criticizing or giving advice, no, you should not do that, you should do that. You have a feeling you want his or her good, but you don't know what to speak at the time. So we should be careful when speaking to others, not to give advice at the time when that person has bereavement, or not to criticize whatever she or he has done in the past. I told you so many times, don't do that, you did that again, and now you have come to this effect. Don't say that way. I'm so sorry that you have this. No, in part of yours, she couldn't listen or he couldn't listen what you had advised, but that you will backfire. This consoling others, sharing others' pain is a real human being. Kalidas said, pain shared is pain relieved. When you try to share this pain, his or her pain gets relieved. They say, when you share your suffering, your sorrow, your pain, it halves, it becomes half. And when you share your joy, it becomes double. So always it's good to share joy and pain with your real friends, of course. So these words make us connect with each other. We need to connect with each other through words, through speaking. Not that we should keep quiet and not talk. In our family, we need to share our information. Sometimes in family problems come and say, oh, I am not informed. The husband doesn't say me anything, what is there coming on. And wife says, and the husband says, wife keeps everything secret to her. So this not sharing of words also create problem in life. So we should share the information in our family life. It is really a problem when you keep things secret to yourself in very close, intimate